Hello Web Accessibility Heroes. Today we will discover the key differences between role alert and aria-live attribute. We will also cover the situations when to use them. It's really important to inform the non-sighted user of the dynamic changes happening on your application, like displaying a success or an error message, or any updates made to a table. All these changes should be announced by the assistive technologies to meet the success criteria 331. With that, welcome to the channel. And if you are new to this channel, I'm Singh. And on this channel, I help you build web accessible applications and share awesome UI and EDA tips. Now there are two live regions that we can use. Let's begin with role alert. It is one of the five live regions. The role alert is used to provide the users with the important and time-sensitive informations. Screen readers will immediately announce the updated content to the user as soon as they happen on the page. For example, a success or an error message appearing on the page. Because of its intrusive nature, role alerts must be used cautiously and only in situations that demand immediate user attention. One key callout here is that the screen reader will interrupt the current announcement and immediately announce the new alert message. The best practice is to use only one role alert per page, because assistive technologies will announce the last visible element having role alert. And second is to use role alert for success and error messages. Now there are four ways to trigger the announcements. First, add role equals to alert to the HTML element. Second, add attribute role equals to alert using JavaScript. Third, dynamically adding an element with role alert. And fourth, by making the element with role alert visible. Next, we have the aria-live attribute that provides a way to programmatically expose dynamic changes that can be announced by assistive technologies. Screen readers will announce the updates when the user is idle or not interacting with the page. aria-live should be used for important updates that are not so rapid as to be annoying. Possible settings are off, polite, and assertive. For more details, please watch this video where we covered all these types. The best practices for aria-live are, first, to add unique text to the element. Otherwise, screen reader will not announce the updates the second time. And second, aria-live should be used for updates made to the table, cards, or anything that does not require immediate user attention. Two ways to trigger the announcements are, first, add the aria-live attribute to the HTML element itself. And second, dynamically add text to the element having aria-live attribute. Now let's code together to add role alert and aria-live attributes. Alright, we'll be looking at the four different ways in which we can add role alert. So let's start with the first one, by creating an HTML element and assigning a role. Let's start with the div and give role equals to alert and have some sample copy text. We can say this is the HTML way. Next, we can use JavaScript to add role to the existing element. So what we can do is, let's create a div, let's give it an ID. So we'll say div alert, and to this div we can give some text. This is the alert using JavaScript. We can use this ID and then add an attribute role alert. Now let's head over to our JavaScript and add the attribute. We can find that div. We'll say hash alert dot attribute, and then we want to set role alert. And then third, we have to dynamically add an element with role equals to alert. Here let's create a button whose type should be button, and then give it an ID. We'll say btn submit, give a text as submit. And on click of this, we want to add the dynamically generated element with role alert. So let's head over to our JavaScript. We'll write the onClick event handler for that button. We'll say dot onClick. We want to perform a function. Oh, instead of hash, it should be dollar. Now let's create another div within this one, to which we will be appending the newly created element. So we'll case, we will create div with an ID equals to div dynamic alert, and we can keep it as empty. Get this ID, but we will find the element first. We'll say element dot append, and then we can append the element. Let's create another div. We'll say role equals to alert, give some copy text. This is the dynamically added div with role alert, and then we have to add the closing tags. Now when I go and click on the submit button, it's adding the div that we just added. It says this is dynamically added div. And the last way to add is to display an element with role equals to alert. For that, let's add a div. We'll say div role equals to alert, add a class display none. This is the display method. Now let's add one ID to it. We'll say div display alert. Let's copy this one, and on click of this submit, we will be displaying that. Or rather, let's create another button. Type as button again. Give an ID equals to btn display alert. We'll give the exact copy text display alert. And on click of this, we want to show that element. So let me copy this click event handler. We will replace the IDs. And on click of this, we want to remove this class display none. So let's find that element, and instead of append, we have to remove the class. Let's say dot remove class display none. So when I click on display alert, it's displaying the div which was hidden on page load. Next, let's add aria-live attributes to our HTML. Let's add our div, and to it we can say aria-live equals to polite, and then we can give some copy text. This is the polite aria-live example. The second way of doing is to add the text to a div which is already having aria-live polite. Let's create a div. We'll give an ID. We'll say div aria-live. We'll give aria-live equals to polite attribute and keep this div empty. And then using JavaScript, we will add that text. Now let's create another button. We'll say type is button. I'll give an ID. We'll say btn aria-live. And then we'll say aria-live. Now we have to write the click event for this one. So let's quickly do that. We have to find the ID on, then we have to define the onClick. We need a function here. And then we need to find this div to which we want to add the text. So let's do that. Find the element and set the text. We can say this is the dynamically added text. When I click on this aria-live, the new string should be displayed, which is this is dynamically added text. Next, we should run JAWS and have a listen what a screen reader reads out.
Alert, this is the HTML way. Alert, this is the alert using JavaScript. The dynamically added div role alert. Alert, this is the display method. This is the polite aria-live example. Aria-live button. To activate, press spacebar. This is the dynamically added text.
I trust this video helped you clear your doubts about role alert and aria-live regions. Please comment what you are using in your application. See you in the next video. Till then, keep coding.